Hi, in this episode of Law Online, I shall be discussing the effect of confessional statements. According to Section 28 of the Evidence Act 2011, confession is an admission made at any time by a person charged with a crime where he states or suggests that he committed the offense he was charged. If confession is voluntary, it is considered by law as a relevant fact against the person who made it. That means that if he has a co-accused person, that confessional statement is not considered against his co-accused person except the co-accused admits that he committed the crime. Although it is the desire of every court to find other evidence, no matter how small the evidence may be, outside the confessional statement, it is important for me to state here that a voluntary confession that is fully consistent and probable has been regarded severally by law as the evidence of the highest and most satisfactory nature. And to portray this point, I'll be citing a case, and that's the recent case of Musa versus the State, LOR. LOR means Law Online Report, 11-1-2019. That means this judgment was given in January 2019, paragraph F. The Supreme Court in that case held that confession remains the best form of evidence against the accused because no rational being says anything against his own interest. So the court believed that no human being on earth can come and confess to a crime he did not commit. Although I believe that there may be an exception where somebody is insane. You can access this case of Musa by downloading Lawyers Online app, which you can find in Google's Play Store. Once you download it, navigate to the legal resources aspect of the app. You will see Law Online Reports, you know, cases, legal principles, and so on. A free and voluntary confession of guilt by an accused person, whether under examination before a judge or otherwise, that means whether he's making the statement before the police, is sufficient to warrant a conviction without any corroborative evidence, provided that the confession is direct and positive, and is duly made and satisfactorily proved. In another case of Umaru Sunday versus Federal Republic of Nigeria, LOR 14-12-2018, paragraph N, it was held that where a person makes a free and voluntary confessional statement, which is direct and positive, he can be convicted safely and comfortably by the trial court, even on such confessional statement alone, without necessarily looking for any corroborative evidence. So this is where I'm going to stop today's episode, to have access to all the cases, the two cases I just cited in this episode. Please visit Google Play Store. Almost every Android app comes with Google Play Store by default. So click on your Google Play Store and search for Lawyers Online. Look for the one that has up to 10,000 downloads and download it. There you can find our legal resources. And the legal resources contain cases, legal principles, laws of the Federation, and the rest. Thank you for listening.